1914, patent 274.350 was granted to pharmaceutical company Merck on their drug MDMA, or 3,4-methylenedioxymethamphetamine. They hoped that it would be effective in controlling bleeding, and they were not aware it was psychoactive or were intending to market it as a product. By 1927, Merck researchers found the substance had similarities to adrenaline in animal experiments.
MDMA was rediscovered by Alexander Shulgin in 1965 under Dow Chemicals. After a student at UCSF described the effects of taking MDMA, Shulgin tries it himself and is amazed. Shulgin passed the drug along to psychologist and therapist Leo Zeff, who helped spread the drug as a remedy to overcome emotional barriers to a network of therapists of over 4,000. In Texas 1984, Michael Clegg, a Catholic priest, deemed himself an ecstasy missionary and helped spread MDMA to the masses. MDMA was legal in the United States until 1985, when it was classified as a Schedule 1 drug.
But I just heard that it's kind of like a feel-good drug. Like, it doesn't make you feel too, like, spacey or anything. It'll just make you feel like everything's much more, feels nicer, I'm assuming.
I guess mostly happy. You know, it's like the emotions are like, oh my gosh, there's so much love everywhere.
Flirt.
MDMA can be a gateway drug as it is cheap to manufacture and widely available, and its physiological effects are not extreme as others, mostly affecting only the user. The mixing of MDMA with other illicit drugs is encouraged as a high is recounted as better. With that said, continuous use of MDMA can have detrimental effects on the brain, as there are noticeable declines in some areas of cognitive and psychomotor performance, and tendencies towards depression. Erratic mood swings and lower cognitive function can affect the user's role in society and social status, straining relationships.
For the synthesis of MDMA, distillation of pure safro from sassafras oil must first be completed. After the safro is isolated, a Wacker oxidation is completed. This uses palladium chloride as a catalyst to put an oxygen across a double bond. The result is 3,4-methylenedioxyphenylpropanethione. Moving on, there is the ketone to imine condensation. This reaction reacts the ketone with methylamine to form an imine. Water is produced as a product. This step is reversible. Finally, there is a reduction. Hydrogen is added across the double bond to the amine. The condensation really needs anhydrous conditions, and the reduction actually needs water, so there's a fine balance here. The final product is MDMA.
So MDMA is basically a chemical that acts on the agonist of the serotonin neuron. But basically, long story short, if you do it too much, it ends up destroying your serotonin neurons. And as a result, you will have holes in your brain. And because of that, whenever you grow old, you know, that'll lead into long-term health implications and everything. And because I'm a neuroscience major, and I Google all this stuff.
Regarding pharmacokinetics, MDMA is absorbed by the gastrointestinal tract, followed by an onset of effect within 30 minutes. It is metabolized primarily in the liver by CYP2D6 and converted into metabolites such as DHMA via demethylation. It is then conjugated before excretion through the urine. About 20% of MDMA is excreted unchanged.
You can get it on the streets, pretty much available anywhere. It's very widely, the little pill presses, MDMA pill presses themselves are pretty widely available.
I've heard stories about like some people giving out like fake tablets or fake versions of it, because like especially you can get MDMA in like different shapes, and people think that's so cool, and then they die.
As shown here, data in the brackets indicate statistically significant change from the previous year in percentages. Although the recreational use of MDMA in older kids seemed constant, it has been increasing in middle schoolers like our 8th graders. Currently, MAPS is trying to complete a large-scale clinical trial for the use of MDMA-assisted psychotherapy. This will hopefully take MDMA out of a negative light associated with the underground drug scene.
The most we ever hear of ecstasy or Molly is in the news, after a death, probably at some music festival. Drug abuse and dance music culture has been closely tied together. The attendance and drug use at these festivals have increased dramatically over the past decade, with incidents of hospitalizations mostly caused by the mixing of drugs, like MDMA. MDMA rarely comes pure, often tainted or cut with other drugs, ranging from caffeine to LSD.
As seen here, there are different reagent tests to assess for the presence of MDMA. Each kit comes with a color chart that indicates what substance is present. For example, the Marquee reagent test is a mixture of formaldehyde and concentrated sulfuric acid. This tests for the presence of alkaloids, which are chemical compounds that contain basic nitrogen atoms.